Well, what happened? What I got into the UFC reality show, Evan is the movie producer. He just saw me on the TV. Wow, Matt Hamill is dead. I'm the only deaf fighter in the UFC. I want to meet him. So the ball was rolling from there, and I just want to make a movie about Hamill. Yeah. I mean, this movie's really blowing me away. I mean, this is all about the early life to a con. I mean, thanks to the message around the world. It could be a good inspiration. And I mean, there's something that people want to look up to me, that I have been accompanied because I've been struggling with the family and wrestling and all, everything I've been in my life, you know. So this could be a good opportunity for all the people to watch this movie. Well, there's a lot of people ask me want to be in the movie, but it's too cheesy. They don't want to become like a pet project, you know, so Russell is going to take care of him, and he's doing a good job. Russell is, I mean, he came over to my house, and I trying to teach him some wrestling moves, you know, hey, do that. I mean, he's doing a fantastic job, so I have no problem with him. Yeah, I mean, wrestling, this is where I mean, go to school here. And I mean, all it is part of my blood. You know, the deaf community, and there are all those people around here. But I'll never forget the day when the first day of a wrestling match to come up, I beat the national hero from a corner. When I pinned him, 300 deaf people were screaming. And they gave him the nickname, the Hammer. You know, so from here on out. Well, I mean, this, based on the movie, it's all about our hope, you know. It's something that gives the people a dream, you know. But whether they want to learn sign or not, but it's who I am, you know. But I'm a father to the deaf community, you know. So whether I talk or I sign, you know, so, oh, wow, I want to learn sign. I mean, it's really not that hard, you know, if that's up to them, you know, so. But, yeah, it's a good, I have a good role model, you know. I'll be traveling all over the world and extend all to the kids, you know, so. But, yeah, sign language is my language, so I'm just happy the way I am, you know. I got there a little late. Yeah. Well, I think they want me to do something with mopping the mat, you know, to, you know, look at me. Right, but maybe Hamill part two. Yeah, hopefully. Yeah. But we have two fighting following that movie. Rich Franklin is playing a role for Purdue, and Dan Henderson is playing a role for, I don't know, something. I'm not sure when it works, but. So we got good. Well, I own a gym, you know, as well. You know, I have more people come up, I'm open up the door. You're the kind of the middle of nowhere, you know. They never heard of MMA, they never heard of UFC. Why? Because they're still in line, you know, in MMA in New York. So we're trying to, you know, passion. If they passion, I'm sure all the people want to be involved. There's a young fighters also involved. I mean, we start from 95, you know, till now. So, I've been fighting for 4 years, and everything's happened so fast. Getting to fight December 5th. The guy who I'm fighting is Sean Jung. He's from a corner, you know. He's a young blood, you know, so he's undefeated. So I'm really motivated, you know. I love to be underdog, you know. So I have more tools on the table. So I'm more like an under the radar. You know. Well, I just got my knee surgery, you know, so basically I'm probably going to take them down, you know. So it could be more of a takedown than on the feet. really, I'm not a stand-up guy, you know. But a lot of people ask me, I'm got a lot better and more tired, a lot of kick. So, well, that's fine, but I just want to be smart when I get into the ring, you know. So, ground and pound is one thing I'll use for the weapon. You know. I thought I won that fight, you know, so I would love to have a rematch. But Big Ben went down 185. I have no room to go down 185. He's smart to stay there. He's smart, you know. When he go up 205, he know where to find me, you know, so. But in my heart, everyone is there, I'm still the top three champ, you know.
Yeah, I agree.
Well, I thought he's gonna fight Mark Coleman, the old hammer, you know. But now he's fighting a Forrest Griffin, you know, so it's nice to be back on the board. He's still in my weight class, you know, so. Yeah, who knows? Even if it's my job, you know. Yeah. But I'm happy where I'm in right now because I have a good trainer, they're the top notch. And I have a 30-acre, all the after court, flipping tire, and sparring. And I got a Trek, Tim Green, but we call him Trek. He's an awesome boxer, you know. So, but yeah, I have a great boxing, you know, pony, so, yeah. Ready court. I don't know, but I never submit to anyone. More time I knock him out, you know. So I got a heavy hand. Good. If I get lucky, you know, for submission, you know, so. No. Probably go to the Olympics, open up in the gym, then a big night, like do a wrestling camp. Yeah. Make the MMA.
Thanks so much, we appreciate it.
No problem.
All right.